اي والله حسبي الله ونعم الوكيل.
حسبي الله ونعم الوكيل. بايعينها عرب؟
بايعين هذا الكلاب.
كلاب عرب؟ كلاب خرطيط قطر هذا؟ يجيك يوم يقول لها يا خرطيط الدور جاي عليك يا كلب، الدور جاي عليك، قول له يا كلب نعيش فوق، قول له يا كلب.
A majestic funeral was accompanied to the cemetery of Sidi Ben Hamal in Sirte after the prayer of Adhur yesterday for the victims of the Crusader colonial aggression bombardment to the residential districts in the city. A big rally of citizens and the families of the martyrs participated in the funeral of those martyrs. Slogans have been raised condemning the massacres which were committed by the Crusaders against the Libyan people and affirm the steadfastness of these people in the face of this aggression. The rallies of the masses of the Libyan citizens, men and women, accompanied with their children, continue their sitting at Bab al-Azizia, singing and chanting, embodying the high moral spirit of the hero Libyan people, believing in their victory by God's will against the Crusade colonial aggression. The Tunisian people in Ras Jdir have got out in demonstrations of anger condemning the Crusade colonial aggression on Great Jamahiriya. The participants have chanted slogans against the aggression on the Libyan people. The demonstrators have expressed their full solidarity with the Libyan people and their leader Muammar Gaddafi in the face of the Crusade aggression which aims the Muslims' countries. The Libyan people, while they are still fasting these days courageously to the Crusade colonial aggression, are celebrating today, Monday, the 28th of March, the 41st anniversary of the liberation of Libya from the British forces and bases which were occupying Libya militarily, completely with American army forces and bases for many years before Great al-Fatah revolution. which liberated the occupied Libyan territories from this British and American military occupation. The Libyan people have triumphed due to the Great Al-Fatah revolution in the evacuation battle. The British army forces and bases have been evacuated from the Libyan territory on the 28th of March 1970, and that just few months after the advent of Al-Fatah revolution in September 1969. The liberation of Libya from colonial army forces and bases by Al-Fatah revolution has set a new foundation in international relations through the awareness of people from that danger of the presence of foreign army bases and forces on their territory. The Secretary of the General People's Congress has issued a statement on the occasion of the 41st anniversary for the evacuation of expulsion of the British military occupation from the territory of Libya. The statement said that this anniversary passes and Libya faces a crusader plot aims at getting our country back to the direct foreign occupation and also aims at their wealth after it had been liberated by the Great Al-Fatah revolution under the leadership of the leader Muammar Gaddafi, and it evacuated the foreign forces and bases. The Russian Minister of Foreign Affairs, Sergei Lavrov, stressed today, Monday, on the necessity to enable the senior committee formed by the African Union to visit Libya and to investigate facts on ground. Russia Today channel has reported today on Lavrov that the military operation executed by the Crusade colonial aggression on Libya are incompatible with the UN resolution. He said that there are contradictions between the aim of the mentioned resolution and information about the continuous air bombardment executed by these forces on unarmed civilians, expressing his hope to verify the declared information on the victims of the Western bombardment among civil Libyan Muslims. From his part, the Belgium Parliament Speaker André Falahou stressed on the necessity to find a strategy to get the alliance forces out of Libya and to prevent from the results of the stay of these forces. He expressed today in Brussels the contentment of his country on the necessity to exert all efforts with the senior committee formed by the African Union to guarantee security and stability of Libya and Africa and to prevent terrorist groups' activities. And now with our weather forecast tour with our colleague Ali Abu Khrais.
Good evening. Welcome to our weather news. The current weather situation for today was mainly sunny day and high temperature in the south weather in general. Now we move to the satellite image. In the satellite image, some cloudy over some places in the south area, but in the coast the sky clear today, and we can see some cloudy north Algeria at moving northeasterly area. If we move to the pressure chart, a high pressure, it makes weather stable over all the country, and the weather next 2 days is going to weather stable over all the country. Our forecast for tomorrow, in the coast the sky clear to partly cloudy, wind direction easterly to southwesterly, temperature ranges between 20 to 26 degrees. In the south area, the sky clear to partly cloudy, wind direction southeasterly to southwesterly, temperature ranges between 25 to 30 degrees. In Africa, temperatures in Sabha 32, Sirte 24, Tripoli 22, Tunisia 18, Algeria 21, Tanger 21, Rabat 20, Casablanca 19 with partly cloudy, El Ayoun 17 with partly cloudy, sunny in Orlet to 37, Kano 41, Niamey 42, Ouagadougou 40 with sunny, Nouakchott partly cloudy to 32, Dakar 25, Bissau 33, Conakry 30, Freetown 31, Bamako 37, Yamoussoukro 32, Abuja 32, Accra 27 with lighting, Lagos 27, Port Harcourt 30, Douala 34, Libreville 30, Kinshasa and Brazzaville 31 with rain, Luanda 28 with partly cloudy, Windhoek 25 with rain, Cape Town lighting to 22 degrees. Johannesburg 29, Gaborone 30, Maputo 30 with rain, Tananarive, rain to 27 degrees. Beira, sunny to 31. Harare, 26. Lusaka, 29. Lilinjoy, 28. Udrein, Namobla, 31. Moroni, 30. Dar es Salaam, 32. Dodoma, 26. Udrein, Kampala, 26. Nairobi, 26. With partly cloudy. Mogadishu, 30. With partly cloudy. Barbara, 26. Djibouti, 27. Asmara, 28. Khartoum sunny to 38 degrees Fasher, 34 Abasha, 33 with sunny N'Djamena, 41 with sunny Fayalarjou, 32 with sunny Dongola, 35 Atbara, 38 Port Sudan, 27 Aswan, 26 Cairo, partly cloudy to 19 degrees Benghazi, 23 El Kufra, 32 degrees. In Europe, temperature in Athens 17 with lighting, Istanbul 10 with lighting, Belgrade 16, Kyiv 10 with rain, Berlin 12, Moscow 1 with lighting, Helsinki 1 degrees, Oslo 2 degrees, Amsterdam 11, London 15, Paris 17, Madrid 15 with rain, Lisbon 18 degrees. The weather for 24 hours, it's going to weather stable over all the country. This is the weather forecast for 24 hours. Thank you for watching. And now we show temperature records over selected cities in Libya and the world. Thank you very much indeed. Goodbye.
That's all for today from me and the technical team. Thank you for watching us and goodbye.
ويعيش معهم القذافي اليهود والطليان والامريكان ايه حلال البلاد في الوقت
نستسلم ننتصر أو نموت سيكون عليكم أن تحاربوا الجيل القادم والأجيال التي تليه أما أنا فإن حياتي ستكون أطول من حياة شريقي
وعاش عمر المختار أطول مما عاش جلاده وأثبت شعبنا الذي ودعه بالزغاريد أن السلاح الفتاك المتطور ليس متطورا بما يكفي لإفساد عرس شهيد واحد وهتفت أجيالنا حول أخشاب مشنقته وآلاف المشانك الأخرى حتى نطقت بصوت الثورة
السلام عليكم ورحمة الله تعالى وبركاته أعزائي المشاهدين نعم صدقت بصوت الثورة فتكلمت الشعوب وسنأتي ببعض البينات والإحصاءات ففي إسبانيا